Greetings, everyone. Before we start on Weekly Byte, I have two things to show. I'm mostly going to want to focus on Nintendo published game, but I will buy a variety of games. Except on the Switch. The Switch is going to be really more, I won't say harsh, but close. So first image I have to show. This is the official Switch Nintendo focused game that I am missing as of right now. We have a lot. I am not going to name every one of them, but it is going to scroll slowly. You can pause if you want to. And every time we are going to cross one game of the list, we're going to have a little video, a little funny video on putting an X in Photoshop, because I don't want to waste paper when I can do a perfectly good thing with a list like that. And I made one for the 3DS as well. And I'm working on one for DS, Wii, and Wii U. I know DS, 3DS is a little bit harder to read, but when I do it, I'll show it, you know. That's the gist of it. We're going to be crossing stuff. It's going to be very fun. And yeah, so let's get into it. All right. So, first off, like I said in the last one, I purchased a Japanese new Nintendo 3DS LL. And I very legally made it a US citizen. Honestly, it's really compact. And there's no AC adapter. Meaning, what you get in the box is the AR card. I think I lost mine when I was a young kid. And I think I don't have them anymore. So, it's actually really cool that I'm getting the AR card back. And they're not written in Japanese, meaning I can probably use them. So, we have the question block. A Mario one, a Zelda one, a Kirby one, a Samus, and a Pikmin. So for those who don't know, the AR is augmented reality, and it worked with the 3DS thingy. Very precise, I know, thank you very much. And now you're like, where's the console? Where's the console? The console is right here. And as you can see, it's being used by the grip I was using, I showed last time. The console is very clean, honestly. There are barely, if even any, scuff on it. I was highly surprised at how good it looked. And before you ask, yes, I did unbrew it. Sorry, Nintendo. It has been 100% homebrewed. I have a shit ton of game in there. And I've been having a lot of fun, honestly. So that's it for the cards, the console section. I'm really happy with the purchase. I was very surprised by the size. Honestly, it's a great time to, like, the Japanese 3DS are still very cheap compared to North American one, and homebrewing a 3DS is just so easy. I could do it. Anyone can do it. I'm not even kidding. I'm really bad at these kind of thing usually, but yeah. Next off, I bought our first Nintendo game that is not on the list. I forgot to put it, but yeah. I bought Spirit Camera, The Cursed Memoir. I was surprised. And when I say Nintendo game, I mean on the label, there's the Nintendo logo, or on the box, or older one is here, usually. Usually more like Nintendo spine focus. That's going to be it for now. It's already enough. In it, we have a Nintendo thing. We do have an instruction booklet. Well, nice. There's nothing in there. And we have a notepad, I think. I don't know what it is, but it is pretty cool, honestly. And the cartridge. Next stuff, as you will saw, I purchased Zelda The Phantom Hourglass. I was missing it from my collection for a long time, and I found it at not that high of a price, complete in box and really clean. So we have the usual Nintendo booklet to register software online. That was a thing back then. A game showcase booklet and the manual. And for those wondering, yes, our manual in Canada, well, in Quebec, were thicker because it had to be translated in English and in French for us. So, and the cartridge, but it's really clean. And I'm really glad that I finally have this in my collection. Then, I finally purchased Advanced War 1 plus 2 Reboot Camp on the Nintendo Switch. I said I was going to buy more Nintendo focused game, and it is one we can scratch off our list. There's a reversible cover that is actually way cooler than this one. I think I'll actually switch it because this one looks so dope. Oh yeah, no, this one is sick. Ah, oh, man, look at this one. But yeah. Then, to switch things up, I kid you not, this is a collector edition that got printed this year for the Nintendo 3DS. I bought Shakedown Hawaii with an action figure. Honestly, it's not the greatest, obviously, but it's still really cool that this shit got printed this year, and it was not that pricey. I paid like $70 on a video game box. My only complaint, so I never actually pulled the figurine out. I think I'll do it just for this, you know. I'll do it for y'all. I'll actually show the figurine for y'all. I haven't actually pulled it out. Honestly, I cannot film with this shit. And he's never going to get out of his box. Ever. So I don't care that much if it fits. So useless piece of junk. That's my biggest complaint. Here's the soundtrack. Loose in the film. I'm just kind of disappointed, I guess. Like, I know for the price I'm paying, I shouldn't expect a lot, but... So, yeah. So, here's Shakedown Hawaii. I actually printed this year. It was a limited release. Because, obviously, there's a limited release. But it does come with everything. There's an instruction booklet. Which would be illegal here, as it is not translated in French, but... Not tell the government. And a cartridge. So it's really cool. It's still really nice to have. I wanted it in my collection. And I think it's still really cool that some games are getting printed. And I heard that there's other company that are considering doing these kind of limited release as well. I read that online. So take it with a grain of salt. But it's still really cool, and it's going to be a nice piece added to the collection, honestly. And then the next one, which I'm really happy about. I finally received my Sea of Star Japanese Switch physical edition. It is a marvel to look at. I got my pre-order with Coin Game Over at St. Hubert. You know the company I keep talking to you all about? So, first off, the box art is really cool. I really like the box art. And it came with a... since, I don't know why, but where their supplier got a close it back on. So yeah, it comes with this art piece. Ah, like that. This art piece, which is really nice. I love getting stuff. And then it came with a sticker. I think it's only one sticker. And a soundtrack. I love getting physical soundtrack, man. And there's two CD. There's this one. And then you can flip it over and have the second CD. It's just a really cool physical edition that I'm honestly really happy they did. For, well, obvious reason, you know? Feel like I shouldn't have to explain that part. Well, I'm really happy they did it. This game deserved the praise it got. And I'm not joking. This game deserved way more praise than it got, actually. Despite the controversy surrounding a character in the game right now, but that's one more thing. And I love plush. If you know me, I love plush. I got another Squishmallow. This one's name is Carpio. And it's a fucking scorpion. I was so hyped. I saw him in a GameStop and I was like, I cannot not buy it. It's a scorpion. I love scorpion. I love everything related to arachnid, even though they creep me. I love them. So he's so cute. I needed him. I needed him so much. I was like, I cannot pass on this. Ain't no way. And for some random reason at Costco, they had like this squishable. They had this squish Snorlax, which is just so cute. He's the perfect like hug size. But I really like it. It's really cool. And I'm really glad I got it. And so yeah. So after our amazing crossing and so as I was saying, so after our amazing crossing of Advanced War, this will actually conclude our weekly buy for this week. It was a really nice week. Next week, I'm not sure how much we're gonna get, but next week is Christmas, meaning maybe things, I don't know. I honestly don't know what next week will look like. We might not have a weekly buy next week, I'm not sure, or we'll have a small one because the week for Christmas is going to be filled. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, and ring the bell. Leave a comment. I read all of them. Well, I read the comments left and I try to answer all the time. So I really love interacting with you people. It's fun. It gives joy to my sad soul. But I hope enjoying this y'all next one. See ya.